Hold on. I have to bring up something.
Yeah.
The fact that we were talking about how the Giants added Brandon Marshall, Bonnucker, and
Iowa.
Why
do you have to bring it up? Dude, you don't have to talk
about
stuff.
It's off the air. It's off the air. It's got to be brought up. We were talking about that for like 15 minutes, and Josh goes, they added Brandon Marshall? I'm like, yeah, dude. They did that a long time ago.
That's my guy right there.
Yeah.
That's why he runs the show.
So I said, how
take
high?
That bong rip real quick.
I said, how high are you? We were just talking about that for 15
it must be
minutes.
The chair.
Yeah,
it's gotta be the chair.
I think it's because you get caught because you have the air on your back. You know, the air is blowing. You don't get as hot as right there.
By the
you
way,
know?
Did you turn the air down?
No, it's on high.
Okay,
dude.
All right,
it's on high.
It must be.
It feels good. It
must be the chair right there.
Yeah,
I think it is the high chair, man.
Dude, I like the haircut, dude. You look like you're like 21.
Do I?
Yeah.
I'm with the Brad Pitt fucking Fury haircut.
Yeah,
you know?
I like that. Yeah.
You like it?
You need a little gel in it, but
I know, of course. I was wearing a hat,
right?
But you should see it. It looks good.
That's what I'm talking about.
It does. It looks good. It looks like Brad Pitt Fury.
Going into
actually.
Movies, just saw Planet of the Apes last night.
Good.
Oh, my God.
So anybody bad. See Dunkirk here yet?
No.
No.
I'm going to.
I want to see that, too. I got to see it before it gets
heard
out of the
movie of the year. That's what I've heard.
I'm going to Laughlin this weekend. So I'm
speaking
of
your mic there, rookie.
I'm going to go to Laughlin this weekend, so I think I might check it out.
You're going to Laughlin this weekend?
Yeah.
What the fuck, man? Where's the
invite? Going to do some boning and boating.
Dude, come on.
Boats and boats.
Wait, you're doing some boating?
Boating and boning.
Who are you going with on a boat?
Your cousin John. Your Uncle John. Hernandez. And Karen.
And
I'm going to admit it. We're going to go see Billy Ray Cyrus.
I'm on a boat!
Oh, shit!
You're going to grab some boats and throw some down!
Everybody is a place in the fucking
are you going with your cousin Johnny?
Yeah.
Oh, you guys better bump this shit.
John will not bump this. I know that family way too well.
Right? He's a beast family.
I'm on a boat.
What are you talking about, dude? I just saw him. Were you at Johnny's this weekend?
And the boat.
Johnny had a party at his house.
Yes, Brittany is.
Your brother was there. I saw Dylan and Daniel taking shots on Snapchat.
Oh, you went to the party?
No, but they Snapchatted like, cousin right? Johnny, your brother's just taking these shots. They're getting crazy with it all
That's
day.
That's my family, bro.
Yeah, I was supposed to go, but I was working.
Oh, really?
Oh, you didn't go?
I couldn't go. I was working. They had scheduled me. I put on the schedule, get me in early. So they put me in at noon so I don't get off till 9. It's like, oh, thanks, guys.
Jeez.
That's what
great.
I wanted once.
I didn't find out about it until like 4 or 5 days before the party. We'd already...
Oh, yeah.
Booked your mom had to go with her sister for her birthday. She already committed to that. And then we drove out to Oceanside. So
there's no.
Go.
You need to sneak this in this weekend.
There's no way...
I'm gonna slip something in this weekend.
I'm their.
There's no way Johnny will play.
I am their adopted third child. There is no way that they will play.
Come on, sure,
there is no way. We always
see you like pulling into Lop with all the oldies, you know?
Just blasting that.
Shit.
We always joke that.
Just pulling up to the Colorado Bell, sliding on in there.
That or you'd have to play that and then repeat with Boats and Hoes.
Right? My God.
Step Brothers.
All right, Knock. Let's get to Shot of the Week Award.
Vikings got nothing on me, man.
Brought to you by Juicy Whip. Cam, slide your camera over to the left just a little bit. Or you slide. One of the two. Doesn't matter. There you go. All right. And Knock, let's get Shot of the Week. I'll go up first because I'm just going to run through mine. First shot, or my shit, goes to the Cleveland Browns because anyone that puts a hype video out over
Osweiler,
you need to get a...
You got it.
Not that. I'm sorry.
You got nothing.
Merry Christmas. Dinner was full.
Dude, you can't put a Brock Osweiler hype video out.
You know what? I respect the attempt. The fact that you have to find highlights to put that
right
together.
There's not much else there.
Yeah.
Man.
You know, what are you going to put, Manziel highlights out there? I mean, really, come on.
You just rip some of the greatest college quarterbacks and just throw a montage in there.
That's hey, awesome. Go some Eric Couch. Tim Couch, excuse me. Tim Couch.
Little Tim Couch will
Tim
knock
Couch. Her. Eric
was
Crouch.
It Eric Couch?
No, Eric Crouch.
Crouch. Nebraska,
Crouch.
Right?
Eric Crouch, Tim Couch.
Right, okay.
We're talking about Wendy's Thanksgiving. I better take
Trump. What?
Sorry.
What the hell was that?
I don't know. I went through like a scan.
I'm telling you, that's the high chair. That chair does something magical.
Woo! Now, Knocker, you're not a huge fan of this genre of music. Your sons are, but you are not. But I think you need to be because people that are playing this type of music. Oh, won't you stay for me?
They're making a lot of money, and I've got to give them. Oh, so good. Tiesto.
I saw this.
You know
in
how
Vegas.
Much money freaking Tiesto makes?
Too much.
I don't have a problem with this.
He made $39 million last year.
No, I don't have a problem with
residencies
Tiesto.
Residencies in Vegas. Calvin Harris is the top. I put out the top 10 DJ earnings from last year. Got to give these guys, dude, their sure. shots and their dues because it's what Vegas is about now. And, dude, they're making $40 billion a year to go spin tracks, take E, and, like,
right.
see chicks with no clothing on.
Not a bad gig.
Turn this off. You're giving me Vegas flashbacks.
There you go.
Vegas flashbacks.
So I got to give a shout out to all my DJs because... Dude, they're making some killer ass money right now. No.
DJ Coco.
But yeah, DJ Coco. Last shot here goes to that little leaguer. That's Boog. His name's Boog. He's 220 pounds. Knocker, have you seen this kid?
Oh, the home run. Is that the guy who hit the home run?
Well,
in
I have
trees?
That one. That's the black kid.
Right.
No, I've seen.
That's not just who you're talking about.
No, this other one is. He's. Have you seen him, Cam? He's 220 pounds.
He
bro.
Looks. He looks like. He looks like the Truffle Shuffle kid from the Goonies.
Yeah, he does.
Chunk. I was. Chunk. You know, before you even said that, I was going Chunk. I swear to God, I was going Chunk.
He's a combination.
Do
of,
it. Do it.
Do the truffle
do
shuffle.
It.
He's a combination of Chunk and the Great Hambino from Sandlot.
Gotcha.
So you put those
okay.
two together, that's him.
Porter.
And his nickname is Boog.
Is it really?
Dude, the kid comes up, Knocker. You have to see this.
I love it.
It's the most intimidating. It's 220 pounds. He's 12-year-old.
Jesus Christ.
Did you see they showed a graphic where the kid that says he like has a crush on his sixth grade
yes.
teacher?
Yes.
What?
Like, we think it's Mrs. Stevens.
It's like, sup, Mrs. Stevens? Question mark.
That's
yeah.
Great.
That's
good stuff.
Poor kid.
So those are my shots. It's for the Little League World Series because that stuff's just fun stuff. So. All right, now
I think that kid that hit the home run. Just
dude, the guy's called it. I think he can hit it to the trees.
I think he hit the trees. That's a long way.
Bam! Dude, and that sound off that aluminum bat. You
right?
know, just bing. All right, Knock, what you got?
Do you know? When I was 12 years old.
I don't think I know.
1969. It's the first year they had aluminum bats.
Really?
In Little League. Yes.
They used wood bats before
we
that?
Had lights, and we had aluminum bats that year.
I can't believe they used aluminum
was it
college,
a special
though,
year?
Right?
Was 1969 a special year?
Of course it was.
It was a good year.
God, people.
It was a very good year.
He just has to, just like how he brings up the year, too.
Right?
They got to take aluminum bats out of college
yes, they
baseball,
do.
Right?
Extremely
you're
dangerous.
Somebody,
well,
man.
I think what they've done is they've technology, they manufacture it to
make them hit more like wood bats.
Yeah, so it the coming off of the bat
not
it's
as fast,
more like a wood bat than
right.
it was before.
It kills
someone's
going
to get
man.
Killed.
Yeah,
there's
the,
no
the
doubt
mound,
about
is
it.
Is the mound move back further in college baseball?
No.
No.
That's
no.
stupid.
Yeah, there's someone
that's
that
retarded.
Kills.
Exactly.
All right, Knock,
exactly.
What do you got for your shots?
Okay, this is going to be real quick. My shot of the week is going to go to Mike Trout for reaching 1,000 hits.
Yeah, and he got his birthday, too.
The guy's just like... Again, three years in a row, he's hit a home run on his birthday. It's pretty impressive. But,
yeah, he's pretty good.
But he's to 1,000 hits. He's 24 years old. He has 1,000 hits. This is just stupid.
It's funny. If you look at him and Bryce Harper's numbers with their age, they're exactly the same. It's pretty crazy, the two of them.
It's pretty insane.
Yeah.
Trout's numbers are better, but
yeah.
it's close. And then my shit of the week is going to cancer. Don Baylor passed away at 68. Don't want to be a downer, but this guy was
dude,
everything.
Man.
This guy was a man. This guy was a man in a man's league. Only guy to win the MVP as a designated hitter. 1979, the first time the Angels won the West, first time they made it to the playoffs. Very good team. But this guy
was
an absolute stud. Yep. He held the record for being hit by pitches, until I think Biggio broke it. But was awesome. He's playing against Bob Gibson. He's playing against Don Drysdale. He's playing against guys that are freaking flamethrowers. He gets hit. You know, these guys now, they get hit, and it's, you know, kind of soccerish and this and that. Charge the mound.
Yeah.
He just stared at the pitcher, dropped the bat, wouldn't even rub it. Didn't care where he got hit, how he got hit, whatever. Just dropped the bat, trotted to first base. Like, you know.
That's a badass,
dude.
Man.
He's a badass, dude. And he was a great contributor to, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, cystic fibrosis and other diseases. Cancer took me. I had cancer of the bone marrow, and you never would have known it, but I still recall the freak accident opening night at Angel Stadium. I think it was about like 3 years ago. He caught the first pitch, stood up, and his leg snapped on him. I don't know if you guys recall that. He broke his leg just getting up out of the crouch.
Mm-mm.
But what a class act. managed the Colorado Rockies in their third year of existence into the playoffs. This guy was just a truly absolute stud, and the world's a lesser place. So, my shit of the week goes to Cancer for taking that man from us. But that's my growing up Don Baylor's when I, switched to the Angels. And damn, just a lot of good memories. A lot of good memories watching Don Baylor play baseball.
Good shots. All right, Cam, what do you got up here?
I'm going the opposite way. You guys are getting the good vibes. I'm giving the bad vibes. First one goes to my dentist. this is out of sports, but I had to reschedule with them like 3 or 4 times. And of course I get called into work, so I have to miss my appointment. So now I can't get my crown, which means I'm going to have to wait another 7 months to schedule my appointment.
Well, tell him to suck my balls.
I swear, once I get this crown, I'm switching dentists. I was so pissed off about this, I'm not going to lie.
I love how
the
your shit is for your dentist.
The hoops that I had to go through to schedule this appointment was unbelievable.
Oh, my God. First world problems right
these
here
people,
on
right?
Sportscast.
White people problems.
God damn it.
I hate my dentist, man. I had to reschedule. Do you know what that's like?
God, I had to
download
my cell
phone.
Like?
I had
you know
to reschedule
what?
My crown.
You know what, though?
I need that crown.
They put me up against the wall knowing that I'm going to get a promotion here, and I have this little 3-week window, so now I missed my appointment, which means now I can't get another dentist appointment, which means if I go through the whole football
season. What's your next shit for? You didn't get ketchup at your Wendy's drive-thru?
Yes.
Right.
God.
The newspaper guy did not get it on the porch again.
My God damn it.
You know what, though?
My socks wet walking to get my paper.
In all seriousness, though, if I have to get a root canal during the football season, if my tooth splits, I'm going to be very pissed off.
Okay. No, you won't, because you'll be drugged like a son of a bitch.
But it's going to be terrible. I don't want a root canal.
No, they suck, dude. Root canals suck.
Exactly. I don't want that.
I haven't had one.
Should have taken care of your teeth,
bad.
G.
That wasn't my fault. They screwed me.
Once a week's not enough.
Stop
bro.
Eating all that Taco Bell and just passing out at the middle of the night.
All right, my second shit of the week.
We weren't buying any of that, were we? I'm sorry, man. We were not a receptive crowd on that.
We're not sympathetic.
No, it really pissed me off just because they pushed me to the edge.
Sympathetic to Don Baylor or your dentist problems? Which one?
I say you can go both. I'm gonna give a shit to Josh for being a douchebag.
Right? Okay.
My second shit of the week is going to go to Mexico's famous center back, Rafa Marquez.
Okay, why?
He's being accused of aiding a drug kingpin.
Oh.
And supposedly being a front for laundering his money.
And that surprises you? Why?
I'm not saying it surprises me. I'm just saying it deserves a shit, right?
No, that deserves a shit.
Did he get caught?
He's in jail?
Department of Justice has frozen all of his U.S. assets, so they're being all frozen. He's being prosecuted.
They're
going
to use it to build the wall.
Yeah.
They're going to pay for it one way or another, damn it.
No comment.
That's
on
for
that.
The foundation. We got the foundation, guys.
That's really funny.
They froze.
Start trenching.
It's really funny.
They froze all his all his assets and. Supposedly, he's got, like, you know, all his businesses and stuff, and he's one of, like, 50 people who are just laundering all this guy's drug
money. Wow.
Then I'm going to go with the shot. Planet of the Apes. Saw it last night.
Really?
Oh, my God. CGI in that movie?
Really?
Incredible.
Awesome.
One of the most underrated trilogies of all time.
Sure.
Coming back.
They're great.
I know.
I like them.
I like them.
Monkey movies, dude. They're good.
Monkey. That's a whole different genre.
It's also known
as Michael Jackson. That's Michael Jackson.
Monkey movies, also known as the NBA.
Monkey movies.
Oh!
I wasn't going there with that. It's actually movies about
and
apes.
And Elvis. Elvis and Michael Jackson had their own monkey movies. And we'll just leave it at that.
Man, you guys went so dark with it. I just went to the fact that I like Planet of the Apes. It was a good movie.
There's apes,
good franchise.
Not monkeys. Big difference.
It's the same thing.
No, my friend. No, my friend. Negative.
Apes will kill you. Monkeys won't.
They still both throw their poo at you.
And they give you AIDS.
Okay, well, then there you go. I still don't believe that, by the way.
What?
Who would bang a monkey and then get AIDS from it?
Dude,
I don't believe that story.
Cocaine will make you do a lot of weird things, bro.
Okay, I believe that more. But I'm just saying, like...
AIDS. Somebody was pretty high.
AIDS getting started from people banging monkeys? I don't buy it.
People still want me to think that Ashley came from primordial ooze. Okay? That Ashley Rodriguez right there, our Miss August, okay? Through evolution it. Came from primordial ooze. That, my friend, did not come from primordial ooze.
Primordial
Sorry.
Ooze. You can't use that word again
Sorry.
On the show. You can't do that anymore.
Just say it.
All right, now.
That's a good adjective.
All right.
I like it.
Knock shot of the week here. Shot of the week.
And that's the way the Texans cheerleader calendar gets taken off the board again.
Yeah, really. That's how we get banned from them once again. All right, knock
Damn
shots.
It,
here we go. Everybody!
Damn, O-Dog, that is the gift that keeps on giving, man. We are still
That goes
drinking.
Down way too smooth.
You
that,
like it?
That,
I love it.
Love it.
Blue right, Label, right?
I'm still drinking this bottle of Blue Label that my boy O-Dog bought for us the last
dizzy.
Time he was
that's,
out
that's,
for the golf tournament.
Dude, that is that's some high.
That's some high. That's yeah. some quality shit right there. That's a quality item, Clark.
That's a quality item, Clark.
I'm telling you, I've even had the Johnny Walker Blue and Black Label. That's some good stuff.
Right? It's your song. It's your music. It's college football time, baby. What you got? Now you got some you got the schedule coming up for the first week here.
Dr. Ross. Dr. Rob.
What'd he say? What'd he say?
People acquired HIV from monkeys by eating their brains, not banging them.
Sick bastards. That's the tweet of the night right there, dude. Oh, he deleted that tweet. That can't win. Don't delete it. Oh, there he goes. You put it back up. All
that
right.
was good.
That's
that
funny.
Was, that was funny there.
I, you know what? I never knew that, though. So I can say, you know what, Dr. Rob, you made me learn something today.
Hey,
so thank you for
know
that.
On this show, right? All right, Knock, you got to schedule the first week coming up. But first, before we get to that, Knocker, you got these comments about Josh Rosen saying, raise the SAT requirement in Alabama and see what kind of team they have. They talked to him more in depth about school, college football. Do you agree, disagree with them? Because I kind of agree with them, man. I mean, you look at it now, I think that if Alabama had the restrictions that Notre Dame or Stanford has, or even a UCLA, I do think that puts them at a disadvantage.
Give me the facts.
At a bigger advantage.
Give me the facts. I don't know what
the fact is that the Alabama offensive line probably couldn't attend UCLA.
You do not know that. You know none of that.
I put my money on it that half of their team probably
couldn't
play.
Give me what their entrance requirements are against. Don't just say it.
Knocker.
Give me the facts.
UCLA's one of the top 25 schools in the nation.
Fine. It doesn't matter. They're losers. Okay? They lose.
Hold on. I'm going to the facts.
Okay? Stanford has one of the highest academic entrance requirements
right.
in
so
the
you,
world.
So you would say it's
and they're
harder.
One of the they're one no they're one of the better football teams there is. Don't give me that. I'm not buying that argument. Notre Dame ruled the goddamn football world
You're
for 50 years
that
with the same requirements.
Notre Dame and Stanford's
don't
requirements
give me,
in Alabama that Alabama wouldn't be able to get the
Don't give me
that
crap though. The bottom
no, don't give me that crap because you're wrong.
It's not the entrance requirements. What it is the scholarship limitations that the NCAA finally put on schools that you couldn't have 120 students on scholarship. Which is what Notre Dame and USC and those teams used to do. They had the two best teams in the country on the same team. Okay, when it went to 70, you now have better players that are going to different schools, and they're not all dummies, and they're not all idiots. It's just the fact is you're not recruiting well enough, and you're not selling what Notre Dame has to sell hard enough to get better players. Don't give me that crap. USC's entrance requirements are as high as anybody else's. They seem to do okay. They seem to do just fine.
The only difference.
Don't give me that crap.
Okay, but with that being said, you don't think that if you had USC standards at Alabama, that Alabama wouldn't get necessarily as many recruits as they are because.
No, Alabama's going to get football players because it's the South. It's religion. People go there because it's
right,
Alabama.
You're not talking about the question, Knocker.
No, I am.
No, because.
I don't think it matters.
You don't think that if USC standards of academics were in place at Alabama, that a third of Alabama's players probably wouldn't be able to play because they wouldn't meet those requirements?
At USC?
Yes.
Don't care.
What do you mean, don't?
I don't care.
Okay, but
they're going to Alabama because they want to go to Alabama. Okay? They still have to get grades. They still have to go to school. They still have to go to class. It's not like the 60s where you could take home spinning and pottery.
No, it is.
And
in Alabama,
and
I can take, I
no,
can take
you
some
cannot.
Pretty weak majors.
No, you cannot. Okay, I'm not buying that theory at all. Everybody's just crying in their beer because they get the best players because they're Alabama. When Nick Saban walks in the door and says, hey, I want you to come to this school,
5 out of 10 of the best players in the country are going to say okay.
Stanford is the only place in college football where you have to be accepted into the university before you can play football.
Right.
So that, they're at a disadvantage to Alabama. There's no doubt about that. But I think in the case of Notre Dame just ain't playing well.
Exactly.
So I think it is a base-by-basis case, but I definitely agree with if you were to raise some of the academic standards at like Ole Miss or Mississippi or Alabama to like UCLA, USC, Michigan, I'll go with Stanford, all these other programs. I don't know if they're getting every five-star, but I mean, Stanford's tough, dude. It's tough to get in. So
I'm not buying it. Josh Rosen, win some games. Shut your mouth and win some games.
Okay.
All right? When you go to a Rose Bowl or when you, you know, play in a Pac-12 championship game, talk to me. Right now, you're just a whiny, criny baby who played one season and then got hurt the next season and you haven't accomplished anything.
I think he's got a legitimate point.
That's fine. People have been saying that for years and years and years. All right. And I'm not buying it.
I think he's one of the most overrated college football players.
Well, we're going to see. We're going to see really fast this year, aren't we?
I think we've already seen it.
But I lean towards you more than I don't. So, Knocker, last before you get to your first games last year in the college football, that football player, I forget what his name was, that lost his full D1 scholarship.
Yeah, DeHarv or something like that from Central Florida.
Because of his YouTube channel. Yes. He has decided, Knocker, that, you know what, screw the NCAA in football. I'm going to go ahead. My YouTube career is more lucrative than my college football career probably will be, so why not stick with YouTube?
I think this is absolutely totally asinine.
By the NCAA,
NCAA
right?
That was my shit of the week last week.
Okay. Donald this De La Haye.
Yeah, this is insanity.
I know.
Absolute insanity. You can hold a job. You can be in the Army and still play college football. You can be on the New York Yankees and still play college football, making millions of dollars playing a sport. Now, they're saying he can't make a YouTube video that's sports-related?
Yeah.
What are you, fucking nuts?
Yeah.
He's not wearing a UCF helmet. He's not doing anything that is against... Or using the school to make money. He's making fun videos that have to do with sports. You guys are absolute just insane.
Yeah, I agree.
Absolutely
Anything
insane.
To add here, Cam?
No, I mean, I think everybody's starting to finally see through all the NCAA stuff. You want to look at, and they always say that they don't have enough money to pay players. I think Joel Klatt sent out a really good thing, or it was Jay Billis, and Texas redid their locker rooms, and Jay Billis was like, yeah, but they don't have enough money to pay all these guys. It's
right.
Like,
right?
Yeah,
it's
but, like they each have 32-inch flat screens instead of their name above their locker, and they have it digitalized.
And the UCLA, the Wasserman Center. Now, you know, some people are saying, you know, these big crybaby athletes say they don't have much money, and they're on scholarship, and this and that. Well, just understand that, you know, because these people are having to take out college loans and this and that. Well, you're taking out college loans because you're not earning scholarships, you're not fighting hard enough for them. You know, you can do this with grants, and you know, your sister did very well as far as getting money, but you have to understand, if you're an athlete in that school, or even, you know, the football team pays for almost everything at the school, period. It pays for all the other sports, all you women that are playing sports, Title IX, the football team is providing the money for you to have uniforms.
Of these schools,
99% of them.
Yes.
But, just jeez, my God, the UCLA Wasserman Center that they just opened this year.
Immaculate. It's crazy.
Un-effing believable.
It's better than NFL locker rooms. It really is.
But, you know.
So, all right, Knock, we'll move on. What do you got here? We got the opening schedule you got for us?
Okay, well, real quick, on September 2nd, we've got 4 games that are huge playoff implication games. And I love this. I love the fact that teams are starting to slowly step up their non-conference games to get a big win at the beginning of the season, because a big win at the beginning of the season will offset a loss a little bit later in the season, still keep you in the hunt, as opposed to the other way around. Losing a big game later in the year really hurts you. But if you win this big game at the beginning of the year, it can catapult you into bigger and better things. If you lose it, you can still come back, but it's a lot more fun if you win. Opening day, September 2nd, you have Alabama. Number 1, Alabama, against number 3, Florida State, in the new Atlanta Stadium.
So someone's going to get knocked out of the playoffs first game.
Well, not necessarily.
But
a loss to the number 1 or number 3 will not knock you out.
No.
But a win in that game propels you and keeps you
you know, in the voter's mind for the rest of the year.
It lessens, right? It lessens your margin for error.
Correct.
Later in the season.
Correct.
That's
give
all
me Alabama
does.
In the game. I'm not sold on Florida State. I'm not, I really am.
Dude,
not.
Dude, Florida State, I'm telling you what, they're I watched stacked. That Michigan team last year. They played that Michigan team. They are talented.
Yes.
They are very,
yeah,
very
yeah, they
talented.
Are bad.
But they're in the ACC, right? I mean.
Whoa, you got to stop saying that now. The yeah. ACC
oh, because
is
Clemson,
now.
Because Clemson won, so
well,
now.
No, you have Louisville, you have Clemson, you have Florida State. You've got a nice set of teams in the ACC
now. Who do you like
now.
Just off the bat? Who you like in that game? I mean, neutral,
don't do
neutral,
it, Knock.
It's neutral
I know he wants to take Florida
I
State.
I do so bad.
But you can't bet against Saban.
No,
see, that's
I can't.
My
I can't.
Whole thing. Like, I've learned my lesson with Alabama in these big games that
I'm going to bet on
Saban's
Alabama. The only
out.
Thing I don't like about Alabama is just running through offensive coordinators. It's just so hard to keep.
Is Sark
gone
there
through
now?
Three.
Is Sark
no,
there
Sark,
now?
Sark's in Atlanta.
Oh, that's right. Sark's in Atlanta.
Sark called the place for one game and he was gone.
That's right.
Lost and then got the hell out of there.
So, all
right, what's the next one you got up?
This is another good game. This is in Jerry's house, Jerry Jones's house.
Ah, yes.
You have the Wolverines
yes.
from Michigan. Right, and I'm not sure what we're going to get out of the Wolverines this year. Last year was their best team.
I was talking with my
father-in-law, and they should have beat Ohio State.
Yeah, who's big Michigan guy. They got Spieth coming back as their quarterback.
Spieth.
Yes.
But they like this kid that's a freshman.
Brandon Peters.
Yeah.
Right.
He's supposed to be really, really
good.
Yeah,
they lost, Peppers, but you've got Florida at Michigan in Texas. Later in the afternoon, this is kind
Florida
of
Florida at Michigan, but it's in Texas. It's that neutral
it's
field.
The
it's
Jerry,
Jerry's World.
It's the Jerry's World
game. You give me Michigan in that game, man.
Last time they both played each other, Michigan beat the brakes off them 45-7.
This is going to be a defensive game. Florida has a lot of defense, not a whole lot of offense. Michigan will probably win this game. You got LSU taking on BYU.
Love it.
I love this. I actually love this.
This is one of your big games?
It is a very big game, yes. It's very big for both of these teams.
Brigham Young?
Brigham Young always brings a good team. They always have an upset, dude. This could ruin LSU season. This opening night, if Ogeron comes out here and stumbles, you
is
know.
Is it neutral field?
It's in Houston. Again, neutral field. So I think it's an interesting game, but I think LSU does come out with the victory. And then Josh Rosen gets to put his money where his mouth is. Because the Aggies, Texas A&M, come out to the Rose Bowl to play the UCLA Bruins that evening on opening day.
Yeah, we already said we think, Texas A&M's coach on the hot seat, right?
Yes, someone's on the hot seat. Yeah. Rosen's on the hot seat. If Mora gets his ass blasted at home, he now quickly goes on the hot seat. So there's a lot of interesting things going on in this game.
It's a good
and it's SEC versus Pac-12.
I'll tell you, that Texas A&M offense going to put up a lot of points on that UCLA defense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, Knock. Well, let's take a quick break.
Well, hang on.
You got one left?
Oh, no, I was going to do some fun stuff here, but if we're out of time, we're out of time.
Yeah, I want to get just a break for
Moot. Oh, my God.
Yeah, Moot, I want to make sure that we're not in, you know, break while he's calling in. So.
I'll save these for next week. This is just some fun stuff.
Okay. All right, guys. When we get back, we're going to get Brian Moot should be on the line with us. I'll go over a bunch of stuff with him. He's always great, funny guy on the phone, comedian, radio host in Atlanta. So he'll be on with us hopefully here in the next few minutes. Get to stoner thoughts. I've got so many stoner thoughts today. And I'm going to smoke some fat bowls here at the half before we do them. It's going to be fantastic. And then we got Wild World of Sports. Finish up the show. Stick with us, guys, as we come back here on the Sportscast. Cam, you finish all that Wendy's? Are you going to go for Del Taco inside
No.
I did the combo today. Be proud of me. I had Taco Bell at lunch. Just had Del Taco.
Yeah,
do you understand
baby.
What I just did to my body today?
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, you just plugged yourself for 3 days.
Yes, I did.
Yeah. You'll be pissing only
so
for 3 days.
I had 7 items today, Cam, from Taco Bell. 7.
7?
That's what I'm talking about.
7?
7!
And it cost you $4, right?
That's it!